Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of Farm Sim. I know, back in the Ponzi. It's gotta be getting old, and I am very sorry. But, like I've said many a times, it's what we need to do. And luckily this week it's been raining, and don't really have much I can do outside of the game. So, we're back. We've got Mr. Moose with us as well. He was having some logging issues. He's in another Ponzi that we had bought last night. And he's really doing a heck of a job for me. Because it's a lot of work by yourself to freaking get all these logs going. So, you know, every little bit helps. And hopefully soon we'll be able to do a little bit of other stuff besides the Ponzi work. And I know there's just the third or fourth video in a row that we're in it. And I like to normally mix it up between the Ponzi and the cutter, but I've been doing a lot of the cutting off camera, just because with the beta it's not working as well as I'd like. So I don't really want to show that off because it's not beautiful. Yeah. I don't know what Moose is doing. Probably an intro. He's recording as well. So, if we've got some areas where nobody's saying nothing, it's just because he's talking or I'm talking or the logs are falling and we're getting pissed. It's just been a lot of that in the past 2 days. Things just don't want to work properly. But we've got a lot of trees down. I think tonight between the two of us, we probably brought maybe 6 loads down. I think I brought 4. He might have brought 2 before he flipped out and dumped his. But yeah, as you can see, the side of the road there, we've been logging that off. We got that hill done the other night. Still nothing really to the right-hand side that we've got, but, you know.
Yeah, I just had another 20-foot long, 5-meter log.
Do you have the console enabled?
Yeah.
See if it renders in like it didn't get cut properly, maybe. I don't know. I think it's the grid where it actually shows you all the red lines, that type of deal. It'll actually show you how long that log actually is rendering in. Because that is the problem when some things are cut with a chainsaw and other things are cut with a harvester. Having the same old problem I've been having with the log, kind of like this guy right here. I'm not moving it, not doing nothing, then it stops. See, I don't know why they do it. It's the physics engine.
One of the biggest things I have issues with is when I go to release my log, and because I'm playing with a gamepad and I hold down and I start to use the joystick to pull down, I either inevitably pull to the left a little bit or the right, and right at the last second it wants to twist and throw the log askew.
I remember them days, buddy. All too well. My biggest issue was holding down that right trigger and moving the head however I needed to, or not pushing down the button right, and my camera went all screwy. Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, I do that. I lift the button before I stop the joystick and my camera goes awry.
Mm-hmm. Been there, done that many times. Then I said, enough of this.
Yes, yes, we know. And then you went to the wonderful world of joysticks. Where trees are greener and life is better.
Hell yeah.
The water is always pure and a perfect 32 degrees for drinking cold water. And
I don't know, man. I think I turned the water into Budweiser.
The tea has the perfect sweetness level.
Oh, God. Start getting into sweet tea, too. I wouldn't praise them if they weren't that good, buddy. That's all I got to say.
Now, see, I just had two logs. I didn't even touch them. And right as I got the head over them to start to pick them up, they just rolled on me.
That's them wonderful log physics, man.
The wonderful world of giant physics.
Oh, no. Yeah, I just had one of your favorite things happen to me.
One log fall and take out the whole pile?
Oh, no, not that one, though. I just had one log fall right when it was over the top of the load.
Oh, that's my absolute favorite.
Yeah, I don't have too much of that happen anymore. Just these troublesome ones that don't want to stay in the frickin' log holder here. Can we get a twofer out of that? No. Almost at three. Does not want to play Nasus log. Oh, I almost had it.
Alright, I'm coming out with a load.
I'm following.
Are you coming out? Or are you coming back up?
Coming out.
Sweet.
Acting a little bit better or no?
Yeah, that seemed to go okay. I mean, it's still got some issues. Like I said, you still got logs that they want to twist right when you're trying to twist them left. And, you know, a 5-meter log shouldn't do that.
I almost think I can control the full lengthers better than I can the shorter ones. As stupid as it sounds.
Yeah.
So I'll show you guys the freaking stack job here. Quite a few logs.
I'm just going to unload. I'm not going to worry about trying to expand the pile. If you'll do that, because you do it a lot better than I can.
Yeah, no problem, buddy. And what our thoughts were, we were going to stack it, you know, high. But the way we want to load trucks is with this guy, if it's going to even be possible. I think it is, and right about where we are at the beginning is just about too high almost, so we figured instead of going higher, we would just, you know, continue on with the rest of the log holders here. So that is what we're doing. And I really would have liked to go higher with it, but, you know, the game physics and the way the machines operate in the game, or the way the machines operate, so, really no need to push the game when it's working so well for me. And that is pretty much where we're at. Moose wants me to expand it instead of stacking, so no, that's exactly what we will do. Big thing that I really wish the game designer Giants would have done to really add would be to add some sound effects.
Ooh, I got plenty of time.
So when you had your logs like this or whatever, and you close your, well, wasn't really a great example there, but you close your claw, you know, you'd hear the changing of, like, right there, when you missed the log or whatever, you'd hear the changing of the tine, the grapple, basically. And also, when you go and you drop a log, you'd hear that tunk. You know, that hollow tunk like the logs would make, so that'd be sweet. Stupid little things like sound effects, you know. Of course, if they added that, something else would break, but it would be cool. I think, at least. Another one in, why don't you? Jeez. Wanna get that one? Wanna get that one? Nope, not that one. That one right there. Come on. You guys need to come down here, perhaps. Let me grab the other guy. That guy. There's that twisting feature that Moose is absolutely ripping out his hair about. Twisting is just something that I've learned to live with. It just does it regardless of how you want it to function. Even when it does that crap. You know.
You almost done?
Almost. Keep having the twisting, like you were talking about there, the twisting happened to me, and they're not working out, but we're making it. And if you hear me repeat myself, it's because I don't have my button down to talk to Moose. I'm so used to push it, or voice activation, where I don't need to push anything, but we've got it on voice activation tonight, or my goodness, push the talk, that way he can talk to his viewers as I can talk to mine without interrupting each other. I would. There we go. That guy was bothering me. Just a bit. And as you can see, the lag that started, just barely started tonight, over on that side.
Yeah, I just had another one just fall out.
Thank you, Giants. Hate to see how many tracks we've got down this frickin' road. It's kind of like the night we were all in skidders. It's quite a few trips. So far I've got 7.5 hours in this machine in a couple of days. So that really kind of just tells you right there. And not to mention we've got two buffaloes going, so yeah. And this is only on this map. I mean, how many hours have I had in the buffalo on the other map? Born home and couple maps you guys never seen, never will see, like hey there, Smoky Mountains. All that stuff was on my old formatted computer. I lost all that. Lost a lot of video. My freaking goose hunting video, that was a wicked, wicked video. You guys all missed when one of my buddies got so pissed off that he was missing his birds as he was shooting them. He threw his gun out of his blind. I had all that on video. I was editing that.
Yeah, I gotta figure a better way place to put my push to talk button when we're doing this stuff, because you know, I'm using the console, or I'm using the controller to do the game, but the push to talk is on my mouse, so, you know, I gotta take my hand off the controller to talk.
Let's just put it to, like, the select button or something.
No, because I don't want to get rid of the select button, because I use the select button all the time.
Oh.
I tried to put it on the center PlayStation key, and that didn't work.
What about push down on a stick? Does that have a function?
Yeah. One of them is in cab, and the other one is brings up your menu or your whatever it is.
It's quite a dickered situation you got there.
Yeah,
pal.
It brings up the. I guess I could put it on my right thumb. I could figure it out.
It's just a click in TeamSpeak, right?
Yeah, but I don't want to step on you when I'm talking about something, like, completely obscure.
What do you mean?
Oh, you know, like, I just kind of ramble on about technical stuff and things that are happening on my screen that people on your screen aren't going to see.
Go ahead. You just talked right over what I was talking about when you mentioned that.
Oh, thanks, baby.
No, I'm just saying. I mean, I'm the same way. I refrain from saying anything to you because I don't want to bother you, because I know you're talking about probably a lot more important stuff than I am. So, no. Just hook it up. That way it's easy to talk to me and we'll make better video like that, I'm sure. You're just a push away. Like, I've got you on my thumb button on my joystick, so it's easy for me to really talk. It's just hard for me to remember to push the button because I'm so used to voice activation.
Yeah, the video that I put up tonight for tomorrow, it's going to be the good video, the one where you're standing in midair.
Oh, the, yeah, where I was cutting that tree down for Landy.
Yeah, the one where you're standing on front of the processor clipping the tree.
That was sick. I want to see that one. Just don't let OSHA get a hold of it.
Yeah, they'll close this down.
For sure. I've always said, safety third. Ah, really? Some freaking telephone poles here. Why does it always do that? Just frickin' dickered. Come on.
Seriously, dude, you're making me look bad.
I'll slow down.
Pfft. please tie one hand behind your back, please.
That's kind of the way you're playing.
Hey, you're making me feel bad.
Now. Come on, really? Stupid thing. these logs would handle a quarter. Like real logs, man, we'd have ourselves a game, but they just act retarded. Like gravity isn't a thing.
How's it going on your end?
Just foobar.
Are things bouncing all over the place for you?
How many times was I able to load a truck and everything else before you had one loaded?
Like 2 times?
That's what I'm saying. I think you passed on the bad luck to me with the logs frickin' acting all screwy. You still having it?
Yeah.
A little bit or a lot?
A little bit. Not nearly as bad as it was.
I mean, then I get solid logs like I just got, nice double, no twisting, no goofing around, everything that I'm doing is just fine, but then other logs, well, now it's starting to screw up. Starting to do the old twisties. Just check and see how my frame rate is over there, and then come back over here, see how my frame rate is, see how it's like kind of jittery. I don't understand why it's starting to do that, and then it's perfect out here. I don't know, it's weird, very weird. We might be at our end for how many logs we can put down in one area. Which really does suck, because I was really hoping to get another bin built and then have the rest of the guys freaking loading and me continue to stack. You know, that way it would give some other guys some other things to do. I'm coming up. Let me know how your frame rate is when you start to unload. Like, if you lose frame rate, or if your camera starts to jiggle a little bit, like it's a little bit harder to operate. Because I think we might be at our wit's end on the amount of logs in one area. Because my logs really started to twist and everything else. And that happens when, you know, there's too many objects in one area. That's always happened. But I'm glad they've changed it to a lot more.
Alright.
Just let me know what you see, how it feels.
I'll do that for you.
Oh no. Drop my Mountain Dew. Whoa.
Hey, so on a completely different subject, how'd you like that T800? In Euro truck.
Still haven't downloaded it.
Oh, you haven't gotten it yet?
No, because I didn't see the tri-axle. Or the tag axle. I couldn't find that one.
Yeah, it's It only works with two body styles. It doesn't work with the sleeper cabs. It just works with the regular body or the small day cab.
Good to know.
It's pretty good though. The only problem is I took a 70 ton. I took a 70 ton load today, and using the I need to get the 18 speed transmission.
13 wasn't enough.
Yeah, I just felt like I was always looking for a gear. Especially climbing hills and stuff. I like the camera on the side of this buffalo, but it's so much of the time I feel like I'm looking at the moon because I only have, because I can only control one axis at a time. I have to raise the arm way up in the air and then boom down a little bit. I'm looking at the sky so much.
Singing a sad, sad tune to me, buddy.
Yeah, I know. You have to deal with that so much playing with joysticks.
It's only one solution I know. Honestly, I never even played with a buffalo. I never played with a buffalo or the scorpion before I got them. In all my old videos, I freaking would cut them down by hand, and I'd grab, like the old Lieber. And that's exactly how I would do it. I wouldn't even mess with these.
I'd use the scorpion to drop trees, because I'm pretty good with it. But the buffalo I'd steer clear of. If I couldn't pick it up with the Lieber, I was like,
One of my best videos was the day I bought my joysticks. The actual video I made was with the controller, and that same day I freaking bought the joysticks because it was just so bad. And that's my video that when you type in freaking Farming Sim 2013 mod on Google, it's the fourth icon or link, whatever you want to call it. And it's got the best amount of views. That and the Bills T-Max one.
That was interesting. I just had a log in the stack just spin around. It's still spinning. It's weird.
Yeah. How's everything down there? Is it handling just...
Yeah, my frame rate and everything's fine.
Yeah, my frame rate doesn't drop. Things just get a little bit fuzzy and kind of like a weird vibration on the screen almost. But then when I look straight back, it's fine. Really hope my graphics card isn't going south. Uh-oh. I see exactly how this is going to end. Yep.
Dude, you gotta watch this video when I post it. It's hilarious, this one log. It's like it's got a pin through the center of it, and it just keeps flipping over.
What is it, on the stack or what? As soon as I get out of there, I can get more logs. That's fine, we got logs right here. Truck coming out.
That was a quick move.
Don't jinx me. No. Just telling the viewers, I wish there was a tonk every time the logs would hit each other, and a clank every time the frickin' claw collided. Would really make a little bit more to the game, you know?
Yeah, it definitely needs more mechanical sounds to it. You know, when you're running the hydraulics, it needs to be noisier. There needs to be more of a clank, like a chain clank. Dude, watch right about where my claw is and see if you see this log spin around every once in a while. It's right here where my claw is sitting at right now. It just, every so often, it'll just flip around. It just did it.
I don't see it. Have not seen it happen yet. Like it spins in place or what? No, like it spins in place or what?
It's spinning, like it's not spinning around parallel to the ground, it's spinning around perpendicular to the ground. It's weird.
I see what you're saying.
Yeah, I'll be right back.
Yep. Fix Mr. Moose's spinny mistake log. Get one more haul and then we'll call her tonight, boys and gals. Like I said, sorry for 3-4 days worth of this, but gotta do what you gotta do. And I enjoy it. That's the only reason why I'm still doing it. So if I enjoy it, y'all might enjoy watching it, and I might be making too much out of it than it is, but hopefully with the next couple of videos we'll be hauling some logs out of here. Then we'll refill them and we'll keep cutting down the old natural reserve here. Get some more chips out of here. There'll be plenty of stuff to do. Start chipping instead of hauling. Just gotta find out where the log haven is here, and I think I found her. Ooh, we got another one right in here. Look at these suckers, just ready to be harvested. Oh yeah. Couple truckloads at least. But like I said, we'll probably stop cutting and do a little bit more. Do a little bit more chipping. And some hauling. Start grabbing these guys better here too. Probably would cut down on a lot of my dropping trees. Think I'd get better with how much we've had to do this. And this is for the viewers out there. I had read the comments. This is my server, not Landy's. And I keep getting these comments on how can I play with you. We do have an age requirement and a maturity level factor, and then realistic gameplay. That's basically our requirements. Besides obviously a mic and to be in the TeamSpeak. And the TeamSpeak is a couple day trial. I mean, we're not gonna go down every single time, you know, a new person comes in. I mean, one guy normally does greet, figure out how that person had found out about the TeamSpeak, and then would let whoever the person's looking for in particular know that somebody's there from either their channel or whatnot, because we do have, I think we got six, we've got Bill, we've got Raven, we've got Deputy, who should be getting back into the videos here hopefully shortly, but we'll see. We've got Moose, we've got Landy, we've got myself, and Daz makes videos. Ian Robertson comes in every once in a while. We got Well, I mean, really, our regulars are normally people that make videos on YouTube. So, yeah, if we don't get to you, don't stop trying, you know. I mean, it's not a don't poke us and bother us, stuff like that. I mean, if we're in a video, that's one way to get banned. But, you know, normally the people that have been greeted get a thing by their name, and that basically lets the person like me that had just got done work or whatever wasn't here when somebody else was here to greet you if you come in. That's just to let me know that, yeah, somebody's talked to you, somebody's taking care of your issue, or somebody has you know, dealt with you in a particular matter. So it's not exactly a shoe in once you get into the TeamSpeak, so don't let me get you guys twisted up on that and thinking that's the way it is, because, you know, there's a trial. We do have to make sure that, you know, we're not making a bad choice by having somebody in, and we have on countless accounts now had to either ban or remove people out of the TeamSpeak because they were either not following our guidelines, or, you know, we've had everything. So don't think that we're antisocial and whatnot just because we don't get to you like every day or whatever. It's just we've been burned quite a few times with a lot of people. I mean, we broadcast on YouTube publicly, so you get everybody from the trolls to the spammers to, you know. So, I mean, not saying everybody comes in with a clean slate, because we've had some issues. So, like I said, we're better than nobody. We just like what we like, and if you want to play with us, you know, it's pretty much that's the way that it goes. Because, like I've said many times, you know, anybody can make YouTube videos, but you guys apparently like to watch us for what we're doing, and we're not going to conform or change just because somebody comes in and tells us they want to do it this way. You know, we're always looking for some more people to play with that are respectable, and, you know, even new YouTubers. If you guys are just getting into the YouTube thing, whatever, you know, and you like to play Farm Sim, you like to do this, you like to just talk, and we, you know, think you're respectable and meet the age criteria, we'll have no issue whatsoever letting you in. So just keep that in mind in the back of your head. And the TeamSpeak is always in the discussion section. I don't know if it is in mine, but I do know Landy, Mr. Moose, Raven, people like that do have it. I've got to remember to make a note to make sure that it's in there, because after my reformat, I had to change all that again, and I don't remember if it's in there now. So either that or message Landy. He is there 24 hours a day, where I am not. So if you message me and I don't get back to you, or haven't gotten back to you, you know, it's not that I don't care, it's that I'm busy. So and right now it's either go through all my videos and answer all my comments, or make a video in the hour and a half time that I have to play the game, you know. So it's either one way or the other. I figured y'all would rather see a freaking video than me answering the comments, so that's what I'm doing. but I do read them all. Even with a little bit of time that I have at work or whatever, I go onto my email and check. And like I said, I don't reply from my email because it's personal information. People we have out there these days, they don't need much to get quite a bit of information on a person, so I basically try to keep all that as hidden as possible. Come on now, there you are, just a little bit of you, but it should be enough. No, it would not. Nope, it was not. The other question that I had was, why? And it's not a bad, I had comments concerning Mr. Moose and his videos and the endings and whatnot. Why would you message me for me to ask him if he's going to do it or for me to, let him know that people watch the endings and... Why don't you message him? It's because that was exactly... As soon as I let them know tonight, I was like, oh yeah, I had some private messages and I had some comments asking Mr. Moose why he's not putting that up anymore. And everybody's like, why didn't they message him? And I was like, oh, well, that kind of makes sense too. it really didn't click. I was asking the question for you guys and then there were... kind of bashing me for it. I mean, it's no big deal to me. I mean, I don't really care. You guys have questions for whoever and they don't get back to you, I'll ask them. But I mean, it just made sense. Why would you ask me? Or how is it easier to ask me than it is to ask Mr. Moose on his own channel? But I guess because you heard it on my channel while we were playing and he hadn't had the video up yet, would be one logical reason. I think that video will be up for him tomorrow. From what he was saying tonight. So I believe that was the one that I was up on the top of the harvester head cutting a tree for Mr. Landy. Oh my goodness. Just... freaking Dickard here. Just not wanting to cooperate, you aren't. Uh-oh. The moose are left. Might be something serious. Son of a gun. Oh, frick. What am I doing? Just what am I doing? Just making a mess. Just tearing this place up. Just tearing it up.
I'm back.
You're back, but you left, bud.
Yeah, I got some issues I gotta deal with.
I figured. not a good time to discuss them. I'm just wrapping up. Just figured I'd let you know just in case you started to go on. Sure, it would make good video though. Oh, and also, titles of these videos are probably gonna be the same. Don't get them twisted. They're not the same video. They are different videos, but I'm trying to get a little bit more video out for the public on the G27 and joysticks for farming sim. Just because there's so few out there. I know when I was buying the joysticks or whatever, and I was trying to find some video just to clarify, to make sure that they worked, besides the one I had found, and there was like 3 videos out on it, so... don't think that they're, you know, triple videos or the same thing. I mean, kind of they are, but, yeah, they're all different in a way. The logging pile gets a lot bigger. Yeah, basically, they're all going to be different. They're just going to be having G27 and joysticks involved in the title. Well, Mr. Landykid asked me why I didn't put it in more of my videos, and I really didn't have a good answer for him on it, so.
Oh, Windows 7, I love you so much.
Oh, boy. He doesn't really have feelings like that for Windows 7. No sarcasm. Just to let y'all know, no sarcasm. And I'm sure I'm about to get an earful. So, I hope you all enjoyed. Oh, come on. I can't end a video with one in the freaking grapple. Come on, game. Hope y'all enjoyed. Let me know in the comments below. Can we do it? Yeah, that'll work. And tomorrow, hopefully, we'll probably have this pile stacked up right just like the other one. Probably. Not going to promise anything, but unless everything goes foobar. And hopefully we'll be shipping a lot more of these logs out than bringing them in. But, yeah, actually, you know what? From the time we started to the time we finished, that's how many we got down. That is freaking awesome. So, like I said, once again, hope y'all enjoyed, and we will catch you in the next video.